I grow up, I want to be the first person to teleport himself.
Even if you could build it.
I've already built it.
Is it next to your flying car?
I'm not working on that anymore. Reed, you're insane. Thanks.
It is our duty, as human beings, to push forward into the unknown. But sometimes, you're looking to discover one thing, and you find something else.
I just want to fix my friends.
We can't change the past. But we can change the future.
I'm gonna need a heat-resistant workshop. And a big-ass sunroof.
They are dangerous and powerful. Which makes them extremely valuable to the government.
You promised me you wouldn't use my kids as weapons.
You think you've had power handed to you? You don't know anything about what's coming.
What is coming?
Doom. The end of your world. And the beginning of mine.
He's stronger than any of us.
He's not stronger than all of us.
All right, everybody. This is a brand new episode of Miserable Boomy Mafia. And I'm going to say right now on a limb... this movie's gonna win the Joe Don Baker Award from us this year, but there's a whole like up till December yet of movies that are coming out, but yeah. This one, oh my! We said this last week. Like I thought Vacation was bad. Vacation look tolerable.
Yeah, Vacation was bad for me because I love the original. The original was one of my favorite comedies, so Vacation got me angry. This one is just kind of like. I knew it was going to be bad. I was reading the rumors about Fantastic Four, about the production rumors, and there's rumors online that there's no like factual base to them, but there's rumors online that the director, what's his name, Trank,
something like that.
He was showing up drunk and high on multitudes of drugs, to shoot the movie to the point where somebody who was working, like. At the, you know, like the craft table or whatever, like the food table, said that he was like shouting that I'm high on ketamine and I don't care at one point.
He should have made a song about it. It would have been better than the movie.
But, you know, it's all like rumors and stuff that that could be, you know, taken from someone who's angry because they're having to clean plates and stuff.
Right. Well, we didn't do the introductions. As always, Matt's here.
Fred.
And Jamie.
Jamie's here this time.
I get to be the
end. And we did Fantastic Four.
Yeah.
You read all these rumors, and after watching the movie, I think there's a lot of factual basis to to the rumors. I think it's very plausible that he was high on ketamine when he was making this movie.
This is one of those movies that's such a weird monster, because when you're seeing it, like, the effects are actually really good. Mm-hmm. They're well done. Like, the thing actually looks like he's made out of rocks. It doesn't look like some plastic... you know, fucking vinyl suit that they put over Michael Chiklis.
Yeah.
You know. And speaking of that, I'd rather watch the other two that Fox did than this new one. But
yes.
We'll get to that a little later.
I'll be honest with you. I didn't think it was the second Fantastic Four, Rise of the Silver Surfer, was great, but I didn't have a problem with it.
Well, the thing that's...
Not as much as with this one.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, the thing that screwed the pooch about that for everybody is that Galactus was dumbed down into a giant space fart.
Yeah,
like, that's what screwed the pooch there. But this movie had so much potential to be more than what it was because the effects were good. You know, they had the gist of the storyline mostly correct, except it really fucked up Doom. But, every scene that you go into watching it, it really just looks like they're reading directly off of their paper, like their lines.
Their cue cards, yeah.
And nobody's emoting. Like, nobody's showing any emotion. They're just like, you know.
Hollow.
Yeah.
The female.
She was the worst.
She was the worst. She played Sue Storm. You never watched House of Cards on that.
No, I haven't seen it.
She played Kevin Spacey's mistress.
Okay.
Slash the reporter who was like. Long story. But anyway, she was on House of Cards until Kevin Spacey pushed her.
No, she does not act like that on House of Cards, does she? A little bit.
A little. She's.
She probably emotes better on that than she did in this movie, though, right?
Okay.
Like, Kevin Spacey pushes her in front of a train, which I kind of wish would have happened in this movie. But Kevin Spacey...
put that cameo in there.
Kevin Spacey pushes her in front of a train!
He pushes her in front of the train, and, like, the look on her face before she gets splattered into, like, a billion pieces by an Amtrak is, like, Oh, God. Oh, no.
What we said, like, after the movie, like, one of the key scenes for me that showed that she just did not care or does not know how to properly act is, like, Reed, Victor, and Johnny all get in the machine that they build to go to another universe. That's the whole dimension. Mm-hmm. Yeah, whatever. Dimension, universe, whichever. But, yeah, Reed's been working on this machine ever since he was a kid, and then Victor worked on it as well, but not with him, and Reed was the only one that figured out how to make it go and come back. Mm-hmm. So, they all build this machine that, like, their college funds this somehow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which I guess was in that little office scene where, like, the guy who signed them all up's just like, you know, they can build it. And it was like,
oh yeah, the poor man's sure? Morgan Freeman.
Yeah. Yes. Like, are you sure they can do this? I mean, it's a lot of money. He's like, trust me.
Yeah.
That's his acting. That's all he does.
He was also in House of Cards.
Yeah.
That's
wow, so. I'm nosing a trend here.
Yeah.
So, yeah. They build the thing and then they decide they're going to go first before they let, you know, astronauts go because they built it and they should take the credit. So they go. Sue wakes up because she's like, no, she wasn't. She was asleep. She was working somewhere else.
Again, this is why the movie was sloppy.
Yeah.
It's like she's no working, explanation.
Yeah, she's working somewhere else in the compound, and she just so happens to have the computer monitor next to her that will tell her if anybody uses the machine.
Mm-hmm.
So she sees it's getting used. They leave. They depart to the other dimension, and she's just at a computer, like, trying to find them. She finds their video feed, and this is what she does. Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Hello. Do you have any idea how much trouble you're in?
You guys are in real big trouble.
Christina Locken in Terminator 3, playing the Terminator cyborg, had more emotion than her in this movie.
Someone who's supposed to be robotic.
An emotionless being.
And who had no acting experience whatsoever. I think she was like, what, like a swimsuit model?
Yeah.
And this is the only movie besides Blood Rain, that she was in.
And that's just like... She was terrible in this, but she wasn't the only actor that was doing that either. Most of everybody else delivered monotone lines, and it was like, most of the people's lines, like, it was like 3 or 4 words long, and most of everything also was like a question that just somebody answered with nope or yep.
It was rushed. This whole thing was rushed, and
mm-hmm.
The movie might have been rushed, but as you're watching it, the movie does not rush at all.
No, it drags.
It drags, like, it is at least an hour until anything of, like, superhero-ness happens.
Well, that will tell you how bad the movie is, because the actual length of the movie is only 1 hour and 35 minutes.
Yeah.
And it makes it feel...
It feels
like 2.5 hours.
It might not be an hour till, like, they actually get their powers, but it feels like days until they actually get any of their powers. And then when Doom finally comes into the picture, he's on screen maybe 15 minutes.
The last 15 minutes of the movie, Doom finally comes. It was extremely rushed. You said about... I have to disagree with you about the graphics.
Okay.
I disagree. I thought the graphics were really shitty. The only graphic scene I thought was somewhat well done was when Reed Richards with the long arms is sitting in that bed they haven't stretched out.
Yeah.
I thought the thing... did you ever see Neverending Story, The Rock? Like the
Rock Fighter?
Yeah. Rock Fighter.
I thought he looked more realistic than...
the Rock Fighter with all styrofoam bricks?
It looked better than...
Okay.
That reminds me of... I went to Otakon 1 year, and there was a guy who was dressed up as the Rock Baby. That looked really impressive, by the way, and looked better than I think some of the effects in the movie.
Yeah, I was not a fan.
I have to disagree with the whole arm stretching thing, though. I actually thought that looked pretty bad.
Yeah, well, the whole movie was...
All right, I don't know. I guess I was looking for something. I thought, like, was using his machine to, like, when he was using the machine to reverse a black hole and tear our world into his, like, as it's peeling away parts of the landscape, I was like, that kind of looks good.
Yeah.
Like, that looked okay.
Yeah. Anything with the teleporting actually looked pretty good.
Yeah, I don't know.
What about
I thought Ben Grimm's, like, texturing looked good, like, as the thing, but, like, his face, way they designed that, I'm like, why did you give him a nose? Like, I guess he kind of had one in the comic books, but why did you give him, like, the flat-brimmed, like, avatar nose, like, like a puppy dog's face?
I will go out on a limb here and say I thought the Michael Chiklis thing looked better than...
Just because you like Michael Chiklis.
I do like Michael Chiklis. The Shield, Kamish... I wish he would get more work. I think it's very sad that Michael Chiklis has not been in anything since Eagle Eye with Shia LaBeouf.
There you go. Well, call up that Shankar guy that wants to reboot this already and tell him to bring Chiklis into it.
I think Chiklis would be great in anything.
But rated R Chiklis and he hangs dong. Right before he becomes the thing.
Which, by the way, the thing in all other movies wears pants. In this one, he's got no pants.
He's naked.
Yeah, and he's got no... You're talking about hanging dong. He's not hanging anything. What happened?
He has no genitalia. Well,
it's just like, he didn't have genitalia in the comics, though, but I get what you're saying.
He
like,
wore pants, though, in the comics.
Yeah, in the comics, though, it looked more aesthetically pleasing to at least have him in, like,
clothing?
Some shorts, or even, like, a fucking bikini-cut, like, outfit. Like, it looked like something...
A Speedo?
Yeah.
Something was there, so you didn't have to, like, question what happened. But in this one, yeah, it's just kind of like, there's nothing on him, and it just looks odd. Yeah. Plus, they had the one shot where he's, like, walking down the hallway. I'm like, why does he have butt cheeks? I'm like, he has... You made the rocks on his body form butt cheeks. That makes no sense to me.
So
like,
he's got butt cheeks, but he's got no...
He's got no dingle.
Yeah. He's got no dangle.
He can shit, but they took the zippy out of his doodah.
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
Again, it's...
Even Dr. Manhattan had a giant dong hanging off of him, and he was a celestial being.
Yeah, in that movie, that kind of got annoying, because you'd see it swinging like every 5 seconds.
I know.
That thing swung like a kid on a playset in the fucking play yard.
I'm not saying do like a Dr. Manhattan where it's just, you know, rock dong every 5 seconds, but I
wanted him to punch Doom with his rock dong.
Let's get
like, it's clobbered time. It's just like, wham!
Let's get to Doom and how terrible
he looks. Look at Mushroom Stamps Doom right on his helmet.
But Doom and how terrible he looks.
Yeah, he looked bad.
That
looked
whole
really bad.
Explanation. And there's the source material for Fantastic Four. Why can't they just do the source material for Fantastic Four?
I don't know.
I think, like, the first one that Fox did actually got it more, like, actually was a little bit more correct than this one. Like, this one... was supposed to save it all and rejuvenate it again, and they... Like, Doom was just, like... He did go to, like, school with Reed and all that shit, but, like, in this one, he's just, like, some guy who's just, like... They find him, and he looks like Neo, like, from The Matrix. He's just, like, got all his screens up, and he's just, like, in a dark room, and he's like, I don't care about anything.
Yeah.
You guys are assholes.
Yeah.
You know? He's like, well, we're going to build this with you or without you. And he's like, then why did you even come and ask me to help you?
How hard is it to make a Fantastic Four movie? You sit down, you read, like, the first 20 issues of the comic book. There you go.
Yeah.
That's your movie. Mm-hmm. I'm sick and tired of them trying to go off and say, like, this is how I envision things. People don't care how you envision things.
It's already been envisioned for you, and it's what people want.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They don't want you to be like, well, Dr. Doom should basically just look somebody took and melted a gray and green crayon together and swirled it around on a plate.
No. You can twerk little things to make it, because I understand Fantastic Four was created, in like the 1960s or whatever. You can twerk little things to make it modern
mm-hmm.
and make Doom, like, you know, look more, give him a better, more modern backstory. That's fine. But I,
when it comes to character design,
yeah.
Keep it the same.
Yes, or similar.
Yeah. Because, like, Doom, like, and I didn't, when I first saw him appear in the movie, I'm like, okay, I get it. You know, I see what they were trying to do with it, but, like, his face looked really weird.
Yeah.
And it was also, like, I didn't notice this till a couple of times looking at him, like, his helmet was actually clear. Because his face was encased in whatever the helmet was when they wore over the... Because that's melted. What they say. They're like, oh, the suit that you went over fused into your body. And I'm like, that's great, because the suits they wore were white.
Yeah. And it's... Yeah, it melt... Like, it, you could tell it kind of like the whole face mask thing was melted in and he couldn't move his lips. And
but it was like, yes. So we went from them getting their powers from cosmic rays to... Doom just sticking his hand in Slimer goo and it exploding and him getting covered in it, and that's what did it.
Yeah.
Like, he essentially got his powers the same way the Joker did in Batman 89.
Yeah, well,
he got dropped into a fucking vat of acid.
Yeah, I was going to say that to you when he fell.
Yeah.
I was like, this is like Batman. This is like the Michael Keaton
when
Batman.
I love it when he fell, too, because they see him just go into this, and then Reed's like, we got to get back for him. I'm like, how? Well,
yeah.
What are you going to save? What are you...
Well, apparently,
he's gone.
Apparently he wasn't.
He just, I guess he crawled out, found some green sheet somewhere, wrapped it around himself, and he's like, this is now my land.
Where'd he get the green sheet? Yeah, where'd he get the green sheet?
I have no idea.
What did he eat for a full year? Because he's in this Dimension X or whatever the hell.
And that's how they explain that. He's just like, it kept me alive.
Yeah, the planet kept me alive.
So it's like,
you can
just say four words, and that explains a year's worth of backstory.
Yeah.
Plus, I love how they did that transition, like, when the government took them, they're like, we're going to help fix you, we're going to make you guys right again. And it's like, they're showing Ben going out, like, fighting wars and stuff for him. I'm like, I wish I could have seen that.
Yeah!
You're like, because this movie does things where, like, something happens and it's, like, 7 years later. It's like, well, nothing happened in 7 years that was interesting?
Yeah, well, it's, they cut...
And nobody aged either.
I get the feeling that they had an idea for the Fantastic Four, which was a lot bigger than what we got.
Yeah.
And they went in and cut a whole...
Yeah, which is why I said in the beginning, like, it had potential. Because I think, like you said, they had something that might have been much better than what we got.
And I think... You look at the, like I said, the whole production rumors and things like that with him, with the director, like, berating his cast, screaming that he's high on ketamine, which is a horse tranquilizer, as far as I understand. Is that correct?
Okay, so
he's high on a horse tranquilizer, shouting that.
It looked like everybody was high on some kind of tranquilizer. Yeah. The only guy who didn't was the guy who played Johnny Storm. Like, he actually tried to put some emotion to it, although it was like... teen angsty, like, I hit my dad all the time kind of emotion, but he acted.
I love the fact that all the actors, like, the females, they're all supposed to be, like, 19 or whatever, right?
Mm-hmm.
The female playing Sue Storm is, like, 36 years old.
Yeah. She looked, like, 29 in the movie.
Yeah.
So.
And she's supposed to be 19. She's up there. Michael B. Jordan, I know, he's, like, 27, 28.
Okay.
The guy playing,
Reed.
Well, Reed, he might be the youngest one out of all.
Yeah, he looked like it.
The guy playing Ben Grimm, he's my age.
Yeah.
So.
And I've never seen him in anything else.
Is
he on House of Cards, too?
No, he wasn't on House of Cards. He's on Turn, which is that Revolutionary War thing on AMC.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I heard
he was in that movie where Channing Tatum is like the Roman Legion, where if you want to watch a really bad one.
Roman Legion? Tatum as a Roman.
Try watching Channing Tatum with his wankster accent trying to be a Roman Legion.
Awesome.
He plays like the South guy who betrays Channing Tatum.
Gotcha.
That one's bad. It's called, I think it's called like Legion.
Legion. That sounds familiar.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like, when you go back to think about it, you get kind of pissed.
Don't you like feel cheated?
Every time I go back and think about the movie again, I'm just kind of like, I can't, like, did that still really happen to me?
Yeah.
I've had a full year, because I've been reading the rumors and stuff about this for like, the last year, about, like, all the production stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, he's out there, like, shouting, like, I'm high on ketamine, and I'm just doing this movie for drug money, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So, I've had a feeling for the last year that this was going to be one of the worst.
Right.
Now, the trailers and stuff started to hit, and some people were like, no, it looks amazing now. Forget the rumors. It looks great.
Yeah, like, when I saw the trailers, I was kind of like, this trailer looks good. Yeah. Like,
the whole time, I
too bad it came from the last 10 minutes of the movie.
Yeah. In all honesty, yes. Like, most of what you see in the trailers is the last 10 fucking minutes of this movie.
Yeah.
Because they spend, like, an hour and 10 minutes, no lie, exposition.
Well, yeah. Don't forget the fact that 50% of the trailer isn't even in the movie.
Yeah.
The whole scene, like, most of the action scenes you see aren't in the trailer, aren't in the movie. Like, the whole Ben thing dropping out of the plane, there's a couple other ones as well.
If this puts it into any perspective for anybody listening, Fred actually had to take a phone call.
Yeah.
During the movie. He got an important phone call. It was 10 to 15 minutes. He comes back. He's like, so what did I miss? There was a montage of them building their device. That's all you missed. And there was three lines of dialogue and a montage of them putting it together.
It was, like, useless dialogue, too. Yeah. It didn't even
No character building dialogue, nope. Nothing.
Most interesting thing in the movie was the guy who decided. Now, you got to remember, we went to a 1 o'clock showing of Fantastic Four, which has been getting shit on nonstop by critics. So, what, there were, like, 10 people in this vast movie theater?
Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. And they put it in one of their big theaters, too.
Yeah, it was, big new release theater that they do.
Mm-hmm.
So, we go there, there's, like, 10 people in there, family with kids, and I think, like, 3 or 4 other people, and then one guy... Is this
are you segueing to your
your people? I just want to get this guy out of here.
Your people watcher.
We've talked about the people who show up at the food
at movies, chicken tenders.
Chicken tenders and cheese pizzas. That one guy decides who he's got chicken tenders and french fries and everything else piled up, decides to pick his seat. One seat away from me in this vast, empty movie theater.
That was great. It's like, as soon as he walks by, too, and I'm like, oh, that food smells terrible. Oh. And he's just like, well, this looks like a good place to sit. Yeah. Like, oh, no.
One bastard. Seat away from me. And I'm staring at him, like, and I'm giving him the eye, like, really? Really? You got a whole vast movie theater? You got a whole other back row? Like,
yeah.
The whole back row is, like, there. You don't have to sit here. And he is just slamming this stuff.
Oh, yeah, you heard him slopping it. He ate that food about as sloppy as this movie was put together.
Yeah, he was going to town, and he was like...
Good segue. Yeah. I like that.
You could hear the food digesting inside him.
Yeah.
While he was like,
I could hear him getting fatter.
So, yeah, that was great. That made the movie
That was
even
the best
more...
part of the whole movie for you.
That was the most interesting part. Was
hearing the guy eat his food, that was the best part of the whole movie.
That was more fascinating than what was going on screen.
So, I don't know, like, I don't even know if I'd... Like, if you want to actually witness a superhero train wreck of a movie, like back when we had in the 90s, like when Steel and all that shit was around... Like, if you want to witness a train wreck, this is a train wreck. But do not go and spend your money in the theater to see this.
No.
Like, if you guys listen to us for actual advice as to what to go and see, I know we're pretty hard on most movies, but this one, like, do not go and see
this
it.
This is coming
it's
from...
It's a waste of time.
Even coming from me, I'm not, like... I don't grade things real harsh.
No,
I try
Jamie's
and give
pretty
it the benefit
easy
of the
on
doubt,
shit.
And I did not like this movie at all.
No.
Well, you know
I was very bored the entire movie.
This would be a good movie, like, when it comes out on Netflix or something to have, like, when you have a party and making a drinking game out of it. Like, this is one of those kind of movies. And I'm not trying to sell it as in, like, go and see it because you're thinking, like, oh, it's going to be like The Room. It's hilariously bad. It's like, no, it's total bad. There's really no...
It's
like,
not even funny.
Yeah. There is no diamond in the rough with this. It's...
I think it's quite clear. What this movie showed me is... We're at the pinnacle of, like, comic book movies now.
Right.
With Marvel, DC, and 20th Century Fox. Okay, those are the three, companies, right?
Mm-hmm.
20th Century Fox, who owns the rights to X-Men, Fantastic Four.
Right.
They're going to be the downfall of comic book movies. They're going to be the reason why comic book movies...
I think it's either going to be them or, Sony, if Marvel gives Sony back creative control.
I mean, that could be, but...
Because, Sony only has Spider-Man, and the last two, like, they weren't successes. I didn't think they were horrendous. Like, I didn't like Spider-Man 2 for the sense of, like, they basically made Parker, like, an idiot.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, that's just because I really love the character. Like, movie-wise, versus what I just saw today, Amazing Spider-Man 2... looks like, fucking Citizen Kane compared to this goddamn thing.
If you look at the lineup, because what 20th Century Fox is starting to do now is they're trying to do the whole thing that Marvel and DC are doing, which 20th Century Fox owns Marvel properties. They own
right.
So they're trying to split it and do the whole universe thing with X-Men and Fantastic Four, where you get a Gambit movie, you're getting X-Men Apocalypse. They were going to tie it, you got Deadpool coming, which might be the exception to the rule for 20th Century
Fox. That one's probably going to make the money unless they really screw it up again, which I don't think.
It doesn't look like
Since
it.
Ryan Reynolds put money into it and he wants to make it the way the character is supposed to be, we're probably that one's probably going to be good for them.
Yeah.
But I think everything else, you look at X-Men Apocalypse coming.
Yeah, Ivan Ooze's son.
Yeah. the Smurf with giantism. That's that's the Apocalypse Smurf with giant.
That looks terrible.
It does. It looks awful.
Gambit. I got a funny feeling. Gambit. They're gonna.
If it even's gonna happen.
Now it is.
Oh, it is.
He is officially signed on. He was playing.
I don't think I don't think it was like that. He really wanted to officially sign on. I think it's like he wanted to back out, and they're like, "Well, we have this contract thing here,
he's producing it and whatnot. Apparently, he's the one who brought up the idea of doing Gambit.
Then what the hell did he want to back out of it for?
Because it was like a whole bunch of small contract things, and apparently the story got blown out of proportion.
Mm. Oh, all right. That's why you don't always want to trust the internet, kids.
Well, that was coming off. I mean, you got to remember that's coming off.
Was that
Variety.
Was that off of Gawker?
It was Gawker. It was Variety, I think, is where that leaked the story. But
no, they're just as bad.
Yeah. No, that's true. But
it was either them or TMZ.
Yeah. So, but. Ugh. I think they're going to be the downfall. I think X-Men Apocalypse. I know to me it's going to be disappointing because Apocalypse is my favorite villain.
Yeah, he's up there for me too. Like in the X-Men universe,
it was Venom until they ruined Venom.
Yeah.
Villain wise, I've always been a big Venom fan. I always have been.
The comic book.
Because when I started reading comic books, it was that time period, and up to Venom materializing in the comics, like, there wasn't really, like, a humongously... There wasn't, like, a villain that really posed a huge threat to Peter Parker, because he already beat all of them before.
Mm-hmm.
And even when they ganged together and made the Sinister Six, he still beat them all.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they gave him a really good fight, but when Venom came around, it was like, this is a guy who's 10 times stronger than him, with all the same powers, he can sense him coming, he knows his moves, everything like that, and he's mad at him, like, he really wants to kill him. And then they cast him in a movie, they make it a guy who weighs less than Peter Parker. it's like, when you look at fucking, Tobey Maguire, and you're like, man, he's more ripped than Topher Grace is. It's like, that's bad casting.
That is terrible.
Yeah.
Like, and then you tell me there's nobody else that was around at that time who had, like, some slight muscle tone to them that they could have made Venom.
It makes me feel like they kind of rushed to put Venom in there.
They did.
Yeah.
They were fan servicing it.
Yeah, they wanted it in there, like, because I remember reading about it. They, like, the studio wanted it in there. Sam Raimi's like, I don't really want to do it because we didn't really even set this up properly.
Yeah.
We introduced the guy going into space, like, that guy's son.
J. Jonas' son.
Yeah, it's like, we introduced him going to space and coming back. That's it. And then they saw, like, they're like, oh, well, somebody went to space, so he could have brought this back with him. And he didn't want to do it. It's like, now, Sam Raimi doesn't always make, I love the guy as a director. I think he's good, but he doesn't always make gold. And, like...
That's an understatement, yeah, in my opinion.
I know, you don't really like him. But, that's what happens when the companies get in, and they're like, oh, we're going to sell a shit ton of tickets if we just throw this guy in there. Mm-hmm. Without actually having a good written storyline as to how you're going to put him in there. And I guess in short of my whole rambling with that, I guess that's why I'm excited for the Batman v Superman thing, but I'm seeing the shades of gray from this.
Yeah.
From what happened with Spider-Man 3 kind of trickling into that, just because they want to put so many fucking people into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're going to... That's one of the reasons why... I've got my doubts. Ben Affleck,
and now seeing
Batman, but
and now seeing this movie that I, Fantastic Four,
mm-hmm.
like this is a movie about just one set of characters, mm-hmm. and they couldn't get that story right.
Nope.
So now here we are. We're gonna have like eight, or it's like I think it's like 6 or 7 different characters that are supposed to appear in this fucking thing.
Yeah.
Who all else is besides Batman and Superman, and
Cyborg,
Wonder Woman.
Aquaman.
Oh my god.
Yeah, there's supposed to be
Wonder
a couple
Woman.
Of
them. Oh no.
Yeah, there's supposed to be. But, like, yeah. I don't know how they're doing it. They should just be, like, Easter eggs or something and just leave it alone. But
I hope so.
Well, the prediction for Fantastic Four, it was predicted to go $55 million, has already dropped $10
million. Oh.
Based off reviews.
Shit.
It was in the last 8 hours. So it dropped from $55 million to They're hoping that it gets 45 million. I'd like to see, as much as I think Tom Cruise is extremely weird.
I'd like to see Mission Impossible kick the shit out of this.
Yeah, I'd like to see that and Ant-Man. But I'd like to see this come in like.
That's when we walked out and I saw the poster for the fucking Mission Impossible movie, which I hated the fact that I had to see the trailer as many times as I had to. Mm-hmm. I was like, you know what? I wish I would have seen that instead.
Yeah.
I was begging you guys to go see the Minions movie instead.
Oh, but I don't want to go in there and look like a pedophile, like sitting in there without any kids.
I understand that.
Plus, they kind of weird.
Grown people love the Minions. It's cool.
It couldn't have been any worse than being a guy going in by himself with a basket of chicken tenders and fries.
Yeah.
Touche.
Slopping around.
He was slamming them, dude. He was. Right. I just picture like chicken skin like all over like his face, and like he got up to go to the bathroom.
Looked like Jim Carrey and Cable Guy.
Yeah.
Hey, Steven.
He got up to go to the bathroom three times. So I don't know if they had like jalapeno cheese or something like that, but he was rushing to the bathroom.
He was not very comfortable after his dinner.
Yeah. his 1 o'clock in the afternoon
dinner.
I don't know.
I kind of envied him because he got to leave the theater.
Yeah.
Many times.
Yeah, I was like, I wish somebody important called me right now.
Yeah, I gotta be honest with you. I sat out there on the phone smoking a cigarette, and I did not rush to get back into that theater. I took my time.
I guess we should probably end this and give ratings because we got to get into a little bit of news here. We have a couple news topics. So, yeah. Go ahead, Jamie. You're guest on right now. So what would you give this thing?
Out of 10?
Yeah, out of 10.
Maybe 2. Maybe
2 out of 10?
2
out of 10. Would you recommend it or even see it ever again?
No.
Okay.
I'm going to give it a 0.
On a dare, maybe.
If they bought my ticket and dared me to see it again, I'll see it.
Yeah, it's one that I might put on in the background. I might have on in the background while I'm working on something else.
I don't even know if I'd do that.
I'd put it on for white noise.
Yeah.
Because that's mostly what the first hour of it is. People, like, talking monotone and just, like, industrial sounds of, like, somebody welding like that.
Yeah, it's like one of those things, like, 2 or 3 years from now where I'm like, home, I'm like, I'll forget what made this movie so bad, and I'll, like, put it on in the background. I'm like, yep, that's what made this movie so bad.
Yeah, I did that a couple months ago, and I was like, man, why was the Spawn movie so terrible? I watched it, like, oh, no.
Oh, that's why.
Like, oh, no.
But I'm going to give it a 1 out of 10.
1?
Yeah.
I'm giving it a 0.5.
I can see that coming from me.
And because of this, because of seeing this movie, Terminator Genesis now goes up to a 6.0 out of 10.
It's slowly rising.
It is. It's rising. I haven't actually done a written review of it, so maybe I should, but like, I retract all prior statements. It now gets a 6.0 out of 10.
Well, this is going to be an easy one to do a written review for, but I'm just going to put it.
I'm just going to say, don't see it.
Yeah. Director was on, like, heavy duty narcotics while making movie.
Yeah.
And just made
do yourself a favor. Shoot up with horse tranquilizers. Put in the first 2 Fantastic Fours, and you're going to have a fantastic evening.
Well, it made me want to go back and watch. Like,
I have not seen Rise of the Silver Surfer. I saw the first one.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I heard the second one was better despite what they did to Galactus.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had seen the first one, I was like, yeah, it's really campy, but like, considering to what I just seen, I'm like, that's campy fun.
Campy.
Yeah, I'm like, that's campy fun that I would take a buffet of right now. Mm-hmm. Like,
I wish they would have split it into 2 movies. They should have done Rise of the Silver Surfer, and then the third movie to complete like the trilogy. Would have been Galactus finally showing up.
Yeah.
That would have made sense.
That would have been awesome.
And it should have been an actual
being instead of a cloud.
Yeah, a space fart. Yeah.
And how bad do you have to be to make you wish for the days of Jessica Alba as the Invisible Woman?
Because, I mean, she doesn't have fantastic acting chops either, but she at least makes it look like she cares what she's doing.
Yes.
Oh my God.
She is, and I've seen her in interviews and stuff. She is like not Jessica Alba, the one that plays.
Well, I even thought I was like, you know, in the comic books and everything, like, Sue Storm was one of those women that was like supposed to be super beautiful and everything.
And
I'm
extremely
like,
smart.
I'm like,
and
this girl is like, I'm like, she's not horrendously unattractive, but I'm like, she's not what I would cast as a Sue Storm at all.
Again,
plus, I think that was a wig they put on her.
Yeah, well, it definitely was. I could tell.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's...
Because doesn't she have, like, short, cut, red,
butchy
hair now or something? Yeah.
But, I mean, the character in House of Cards You gotta remember the character Kevin Spacey plays, you're supposed to hate him.
Yeah.
And you're kind of rooting for him pushing this chick from the train. You're kind of like, well, you know, I can understand, you know, I can understand why he did that. Like,
yeah. You're going to hire Kevin Spacey to push this movie in front of a train.
Yeah, it's this one. I hope people don't go out and see it, because if it makes $45 million, then they're going to spit out a sequel.
I hope
Well, not. You heard it from us. It's a 2 and below. So yeah. That's probably one of the lowest ratings on here, I would believe. Because you can't take the Terminator Genesis ones, because I'm retracting what I said with that. And I think with Vacation, I at least gave it a 2, if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We gave it 2s around the board.
That's right. We all agreed the same on that. So this is in the top running for the Joe Don Baker Award for the most, goddammits.
For me, it's 3. It's Vacation, it's this, and it's Hot Pursuit.
Those would be the 3. Hot Pursuit was pretty bad.
We've been doing this for so long now. Hot Pursuit's
way back, and this makes Hot Pursuit look fucking fantastic.
Yeah,
like,
which I have to admit, I picked it up out of the Red Box. I got Hot this. Pursuit. I got this and Unfriended out of the Red Box. So
do not watch them.
We'll see.
So, okay, we're going to roll into a little bit of news. Since we saw Fantastic Four today, there is a very independent director, I guess you could say. I can't remember his first name, but I know his last name is, like, Shankar. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. We had talked about this on Grindcast a little bit, but he wants to, which already shows you how bad this movie is, he wants to already reboot the Fantastic Four.
He wanted to reboot it as of Wednesday.
Yeah. Before this even came out. Yeah. He wanted to reboot it already. Now, this guy is known for doing an independent Power Rangers film. With James Van Der Beek. And what was the other one?
He did The Gray.
The Gray, which is a fantastic
fucking movie. He did another movie as well that...
I give The Gray like 9.0 out of 10. That's like a fantastic movie.
I still want to see it. I haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, that one's good. He did some other stuff.
Yeah. Look him up if you want to know his filmography or whatever. But yeah, he wants to reboot this already. So, I think it would be funny if they let him do it. Like, say this one makes money, and they're like, you know what, we don't want a reboot, but you can do the sequel. And a guy that dresses up like the Crow makes a better fucking movie.
Yeah, this guy dresses up like he puts mascara on like he's the Crow.
Yeah.
When he's, like, going to the grocery store. So. Yep.
Alright.
I would love it if a guy like that makes a better movie than somebody who was supposed to be contracted as a professional director, who's just fucking doing it for drug money, like you said. Yeah.
I guess we should put allegedly. But after watching the movie, I think we could probably push
I think everybody, like I said, I think all of them were on fucking horse tranquilizers. The only one was, like, the guy who played Johnny Storm. He's like, nah, I'm good, guys. If you want me to just act monotone, I can. I don't need to be under the influence.
Yes. But, yeah, let them do it. What's the worst that can happen? You're not going to get worse than...
Yeah, the best thing that can happen is he actually makes a good movie and he saves the fucking franchise.
Yeah. He did another fan film, too, besides Power Rangers. I forget.
Oh, wow. You remember how we went into the movie and she looked up what it was rated on Rotten Tomatoes, Fantastic Four? It was like a 12. Now it's a 9.
9%.
Yeah, it dropped when I was in the theater. I showed you. It already dropped down to a 10.
That's incredible.
Yep.
But anyway, yeah, so Sony had released their movies coming out.
Yeah, and it's pretty bad, in my opinion. 16 movies up through 2019. You've got Bad Boys 3 and 4.
Yeah, we had touched on that in Grindcast. And I said on that, I was like, you know what? Like, I guess they thought, like, you know, I guess Will Smith's being Deadshot now, so he's getting back in the movies, and I know Martin Lawrence ain't doing anything.
Yeah.
Let's make some more bad... And it's not just one. They get the balls and they're like, we're going to make 2 of them.
I didn't like any of them. Like,
I never watched any of them.
You're not missing anything. You're not. They're terrible.
Yeah.
It's like the first one, they try to rescue Taya Leone from a drug lord. And the second one, I only got 15 minutes in before I said, fuck you, Michael Bay, and threw my remote control across the room. They're terrible. Of course, Ghostbusters got moved up a week.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, I want to get into that.
Which I think it was funny that they like, oh, it's coming out sooner by 1 week.
I love this. The fact that Ghostbuster, there's a Facebook thing called GhostbusterFans.com that posts updates. And every time they post an update with the all-female cast, It is. This saves my hope for humanity. It is nothing but negative comments. Like who's going to go see Ghostbusters? It's been pushed up 1 week and you have like 400 comments saying, I'm not. I'm watching the original. This looks like shit. And it's 400 comments of that, all right? Now, they posted pictures this week of the four females who are playing Ghostbusters visiting a children's hospital.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they put those up there, and of course, here they come. And they started bombing those pictures saying, that poor kid, they showed up at the hospital to show these kids there's no hope for the future and they can just give up and stuff like that.
Oh, that's terrible.
That's awful.
That is terrible.
Oh, come on.
Wow.
Well,
I mean, the internet is a really terrible place, but Jesus Christ. I mean, like, when I saw those pictures, I was like, that's nice that they're doing something like that, because not a lot of actors, like, reach out like that. I mean, like, some of...
There was, like, 500 negative comments.
That's just terrible.
Wow. Under this thing. And, well, look, the movie's got to be terrible.
Yeah, but you don't have to be like, yeah, these kids might as well just die now because there's no hope. It's like, it's just fucking Ghostbusters. Like, come on.
But I hope that movie bombs financially. All right.
I'm well, sure
maybe the sick kids in the hospital, that was a little too much, but...
A little?
It'll get a slightly better score on Rotten Tomatoes compared to Fantastic Four and The Last Airbender.
I sent you the link to it on your Facebook. You'd have to look.
Oh my god.
It was brutal. It was brutal. But they showed what the packs and stuff look like.
Right. Do they not look the same? No,
it is. They look like kind of like...
Well, I saw like what the guns looked like. They didn't look right either. They looked almost more like the slime guns that they had in the second movie. Well, no, because those were like a big canister, I guess.
Looks like a toaster with a sex toy coming out of the side of it to me. But that's what it looked like.
Interesting.
But they beat up on that. But all right, Ghostbusters. Besides the sick children.
Yeah.
Which
I think I said they were doing another D&D movie. I'm not sure if that was Sony, but I heard that was in the pipeline.
They're doing Jumanji.
Oh no!
What? Man.
They're rebooting Jumanji. That's Christmas of 2016.
Can we just?
Leave it alone.
Like, he died. Can we just let that alone?
Yeah, leave it alone.
Yeah, it was okay the way it was. It was like maybe, awesome, but
are
it was
they,
okay.
Is it a sequel or are they redoing it?
They're rebooting it. They're rebooting.
See, I'd rather take a sequel and just being like, it's one of his kids found it.
Yeah, or like...
And just like, you know, honor his memory that he was in this movie and just leave it alone. You don't need to redo it and have somebody else, like, play his part.
Agreed.
Just let it alone.
It's. I agree with that. Leave it alone. What was the other... I know you'll be excited for this. Underworld 5 will be coming out right before.
We're up to 5?
Yeah, you had 1 and 2, then Rise of the Lycans, and then that Evolution
one. I feel
Evolution
like they should just change the titles to not another Underworld movie.
There's one that we should have Underworld Month on
for.
Where we just go through all...
I can tolerate the first and the second one, but after that point, I think I quit.
I think I can tolerate...
That third one put me to sleep.
Yeah,
I think I can tolerate 20 minutes of the first one, and that's about it.
That's the thing. Like, that's one of those movies that does not get better with the time. Mm-mm. Because, like, it was shot in that, you know, going into the millennium, like, super tued, you know, like... Gothic, like, it was coming off of the Matrix stuff, so it was like everybody in trench coats and
everybody.
Like, because they're vampires, they're all gonna be brooding and mean and it's like
gun-toting assholes.
Yeah, it's like, oh, we're gonna have the werewolf vampire hybrid.
I could watch it if someone would just stream together all the parts with Kate Beckinsale. Everything else out. If it's
just shots of Kate Beckinsale, like, twisting.
Yeah. Anyone on YouTube, if you want to take that idea,
I'm sure it's on there.
It's probably already there. You just gotta look for it.
Yeah, I'm dead sure it's probably there.
Just stream.
They probably stream some of her, like, half-naked pictures in there, too, just for your enjoyment.
That's fine by me. And she's broke now, so she's trying to do, like, Underworld movies.
That's not going to save you.
No.
Nope. Well, they'll pay her for them, and she's starting to go the route of Nicolas Cage.
She was in that movie recently about, like, it was, like, about the insane asylum. Like, Ben Kingsley was in it with her, and I forget what it was, but it was, like, shot, like, in old-timey England and everything, and that bombed terribly. It was, like, made for Netflix movie, I think.
Yeah. Total Recall was the last one she was in that movie.
Oh, God,
Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell.
Not the cool Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yeah, that, reboot that wasn't so good.
I would happily take that one over the reboot.
Yeah, the reboot was... That's another one terrible. I only watched like 20 minutes of.
Yeah.
But that, Equalizer 2 was another one.
I didn't even see the first one.
The first one was actually pretty good.
Yeah.
But Equalizer 2, so...
Is Sony the ones...
Yep.
Behind the Hitman series?
No.
I don't know why, I just feel like they had their hands in everything.
They have their hands in a lot of stuff.
Last year was really rough for them.
Well, yeah.
Apparently,
movies. I think it was last year? No, that was 2 years ago, it was Amazing Spider-Man. But, like, after that, they didn't... Yeah, they didn't put much out in the theater.
Yeah, 2014 was Amazing Spider-Man 2,
was it?
Right?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I could see that being a rough year for them.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, it was, so.
Yeah.
Were there any other movies you could think of off the top of your head that were on that list of 16?
That was it.
Okay. Because, yeah, there were some, like, and I'm kind of happy to see this. Some of them are actually, like, original projects, so, mm-hmm. like, that's good. Yeah, I'd like to see some of that stuff, so. I think that's going to be it for news, and I think that'll be the end of this episode then, so see Fantastic Four, and...
I got to call another company wants to do a job interview.
Yeah, it's looking a little abysmal for the future, too. So, all right, well, you know, as always, guys, you can find us on iTunes, grindedword.com, miserablemoviemafia.wordpress.com, podcast source, and on our YouTube channel, The Grinded Word. Until next time, thank you for listening, and we'll catch you later.